Now let's take a look at the Netherlands and see how this country is consolidating its position as a pioneer in circular economy, promoting initiatives and investments in incubators and innovative startups. This is a very important point. And now let's have the honor and the pleasure to listen to the General Consul of the Kingdom of the Netherlands in Milan, Johan Verboom. Welcome.
It's also a great pleasure for me to participate in this important event. I am living and working in Milan since 3 years, and I'm doing that with a lot of pleasure. I very much enjoy living and working in Italy. Special thanks to Francesco and the team of Tondo. We have been working together before, and I'm impressed by the quality of the work of Tondo and also the important job you are doing in promoting the circular economy. We, as a Consulate General, we very much try to work under an umbrella of sustainability and also the sustainable development goals. We are using them and we have made them leading in our working programs. I'm also very happy to see that in this forum, a number of Dutch innovative companies are participating, and hopefully it will further boost the cooperation between Dutch and Italian organizations. Well, we have seen in recent years that the circular economy transition, that it's receiving a lot of attention by governments, by companies, by businesses, by universities, all kinds of organizations, non-profit organizations. And that's very important. And now with the corona crisis, I think people are even becoming more aware that we have to change, that we have to change our behavior, that we have to do things differently. And hopefully it will help in our process to really do things differently and to move on to a more circular economy. In this context, the 2030, I think you can move to the next slide. Well, in this context, the UN Agenda 2030 for Sustainable Development and also the Paris Climate Agreement are extremely important, and they form a very good framework. And at policy levels, it is kind of agreed that the circular economy is one of the solutions for our environmental problems. But it's also a very important economic opportunity. The EU expects the transition to a circular economy to boost economic growth by 550 billion euros, as you can see on the slide, and also to create 2 million jobs. McKinsey expects an economic benefit for Europe of 1.8 trillion euro by 2030. The EU is one of the most active organizations supporting this transition. Yesterday you heard already a couple of programs which were presented, like the circular economy package and the EU action plan for the circular economy, and also the Green Deal, which was recently announced. And within this European framework, the Netherlands also has set very ambitious goals. By 2030, we aim for a reduction of 50% of the consumption of raw material. And by 2050, so in 30 years, we aim to have a fully circular society. To this end, the Dutch government has prepared a program for a circular economy. And within this program, we have set three main targets. First, we want to produce in a more efficient way, which will lead to the use of fewer raw materials, so more efficiently. Secondly, when new raw materials are needed, we will use sustainably produced renewable raw materials. like for example, biomass. This will also make the Netherlands less dependent on fossil fuels. And thirdly, new production methods, which are more sustainable, and new products, which new products, new circular products will have to be designed. So these three targets we are investing in. The Netherlands also has established a specific agenda for five industry sectors, which are very relevant to the Dutch economy and which also have a great impact on the environment. And these five sectors are the following: biomass and food, plastics, manufacturing, real estate and construction, and also consumer goods. Further, the Dutch government is amending legislation that stands in the way of a transition to a circular economy. And if I may give a couple of examples, the government is encouraging circular procurement. We heard a little bit about this also in the presentation before mine from the city of Milan. But all public authorities in the Netherlands have to strive for the reduction of carbon emissions through circular procurement. For example, Rijkswaterstaat, which is responsible for road construction, is experimenting with building a viaduct from reusable components. You can see this in the picture. And also another example is the Ministry of Defense, which is having parts of its equipment made from recycled parts of old military equipment. Also, the government is making use of price incentives, which is also done in Italy, to encourage manufacturers to opt for recycled or bio-based materials and to encourage consumers to choose sustainable products. Further, the government has, together with a number of business organizations, established an internet portal called Versnellingshuis. This is Dutch for Circular Economy Accelerator. And it's supposed to help to support businesses with their plans to operate more circular. Also worthwhile is mentioning PACE. PACE is the platform for accelerating the circular economy, and which was recently created by the World Economic Forum. This platform, this internet platform, is hosted by the Netherlands, and I can recommend to visit this platform because it has a number of very nice presentations of projects and some very interesting ideas. Well, let me come a little bit to the end of my presentation. We can conclude that already a lot is happening, a lot has been done, but still really a lot has to be done. And this is for the Netherlands, this is valid for the Netherlands, for Italy, for Europe, worldwide. And we feel that key in this is international cooperation. We have to work together. We have to learn from each other. We have to share best practices as we are doing today. And I'm also very pleased to inform you that next week we will have the visit of our Minister for Foreign Trade, Minister Kaag. She will visit Italy. Unfortunately, we had to decide to do it in a digital form, but still she will visit Italy together with a large group of organizations and companies in the sectors of fashion and textiles, very important for with an eye on the circular economy, and also in water technology. And all these companies, they will partner up with Italian organizations and companies. She will also participate in Ecomondo in Rimini, and she will make a nice keynote speech there. I'm very happy to say that the cooperation between the Netherlands and Italy is already very excellent and also very promising. All kinds of forms of cooperation at different levels have been established between cities, Milan and Rotterdam, Milan and Amsterdam, companies, startups, research institutions, universities. Because there are many areas where the Netherlands can learn from Italy, and also where the Netherlands has to offer some interesting, innovative solutions. So again, I'm very happy to participate in this event, in this digital event, and I hope it will help to further strengthen the cooperation between our two countries. Thank you very much for your attention, and please feel free to contact us at the consulate in Milan and or to pass by, and you can also find us at the different social media. Thank you.
I just want to personally thank John Verboom for the support for the event. It has been really a pleasure to collaborate with you during this time and to invite all the Dutch companies that will follow. There was already one yesterday, also a Dutch person. As you know, I'm personally attached to the Netherlands, and also we are trying also to create a business connection. So again, thanks, and let Celia continue and in the introduction of the other speaker. Celia, you are in mute. You are in mute. You can mute yourself. If you can't, continue.
Yes.
Okay, great.
Yes, yes we can. Sorry. We are all of us. We are trying to cope with the new technologies and this kind of virtual webinars and conference together. I would like to ask just the general counsel if he's still. Yes, he's
yes.
Still there. He's still there. I would like to ask you if the pandemic crisis will speed up the cooperation between countries in Europe and will speed up the adoption of solutions to circular economy.
I hope so. I really hope so. In any case, I think it will. It is making us aware that we have to work together, because the environment and also health issues like the corona crisis, they are not respecting borders. And we have to work together, otherwise we cannot move on. And we can, so I really think that it is in that respect supporting our efforts.